Oscar Lopez, the patriarch of the Lopez family, will step down as CEO of First Philippine Holdings effective June 12, as he hands over the reins of the company to his son. Alvin Antico reports.
After 25 years as Chief Executive Officer of First Philippine Holdings, Oscar Lopez relinquishes his post during the company's 48th annual stockholders meeting Monday. The 80-year-old patriarch recommended his son, Federico Piki Lopez, who is also the firm's Managing Director for Energy, to succeed him as CEO and Chairman beginning June 12.
To be sure, I don't want to step completely out of the picture. I would like to remain active as your Chairman Emeritus, so that I will still be in a position to contribute to the corporation, especially with regards to the long-term strategy of this company.
Lopez's career spanned 50 years since returning from the United States in 1960. From Manila Chronicle to Meralco to First Philippine Industrial Corporation and now First Philippine Holdings, Lopez honed his management and business skills over the last five decades. In his final speech as CEO and chairman before stockholders, Lopez recalled his family struggle with the Marcos dictatorship, where First Holdings was forced to sell Meralco, its most valuable asset. After the first EDSA revolution, Oscar Lopez was instructed by then-President Cory Aquino to take over the leadership of First Philippine Holdings. But the challenges were enormous, 1.2 billion pesos in liabilities and only 26 million pesos in liquid assets.
As I think back to that day, even now, I feel that the natural reaction of a reasonable man would have been to decline the appointment on the grounds that to save First Holdings was an impossible task. But something moved me to do otherwise. I still remember it was Jake Almeida Lopez, who is still with us as a board member of this company, who reminded me that this was a company, a business that my father had created, had fought for, and had died for. To honor him, I could do no less than give my utmost, win or lose, to try to save the company.
Fast forward to the present, First Philippine Holdings has 148.8 billion pesos in total assets and over 25 billion pesos in cash reserves.
It is the dream and aspirations of every professional manager, of every business leader, to live the business in better condition than when he or she first assumes responsibility for it. This is in accord with the law of stewardship. Modesty aside, I think that I have earned the right to make that claim. And within the pantheon of Lopez business leaders, I'm certain that my father and brother are smiling down on me for a job well done. I also hope to try to be in the tradition of the two Lopezes who preceded me, namely my father and elder brother Henny, who died with their boots on in the service of their companies. I also hope to continue seeing some, if not all of you, once in a while in the coming years. If not, I will definitely see all of you in the next life.
Federico Lopez, the incoming chairman and CEO, accepts the challenge of steering the company in the years to come.
I guess we have to prepare the groundwork also for us to go international, to go global, so that we can continue growth there with the power generation business. But again, like even in the first gen stockholders meeting, I may have told you that we have a lot to do locally. Just revving up our EDC investment, making sure that it does perform, no? and everything else that we have, no? The hydro, geothermal, and even the gas, making sure that the whole generation portfolio operates as a very strong portfolio.
While Oscar Lopez's brother, Manuel Manolo Lopez, had also relinquished his post as CEO of Meralco earlier last week, the patriarch assured investors the Lopezes will retain their 6.6% stake in the power utility. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.